Hi, welcome to this video. For those that don't know me, my name is Christopher Edgett. I'm from VelocityAP. I handle all the tuning departments, technical support, stuff like that. In this video today, we're going to be talking about the Griptec pulley, how we're going to get it installed on the supercharger. So for demonstration purposes right now, I have a TVS 1320. This is the supercharger most found on the 3-liter supercharged Jaguar Land Rover engines, F-Type, XE, Range Rover Sport, full size, stuff like that, XF as well. So any of the 3-liter supercharged cars. Now, if you have a 5-liter, doesn't really matter. We're going to be able to do the exact same installation procedure to get this onto your vehicle. However, we'll be using a 58-millimeter pulley for this demonstration. For your vehicle on a 5-liter, that's what you have. You cannot use the 58 without doing any modifications to the snout. What I mean by that is if you look on this 3-liter, it's actually already milled down, comes like that from the factory. The 5-liter, it's not. It's like a rough cast finish. So you'd have to shave this down in order to fit a 58. That is why we have the 62.7 mil for you 5-liter guys. So that's already available on the website. But like I said, today we're going to be doing the 58 mil. So once you have the pulley off, basically, this is the stock pulley. You can use tools like this right here. Basically, the pulley goes inside, kind of deal, and it just pulls off. So it'll go over the snout, and it just comes off. There are other tools on the market. This is just something we picked up on eBay. I think it was a Superchargers Online or something like that. I don't know if they still have or not. It's just something we picked up over the years. They also have ones from ECS Tuning. They have one for their 3-liter Audis. It works okay on the 3-liter Jags. The 5-liter Jags, it works as well unless you have an early car. The only issue with the early car is the outside or the outer lip right here. You'll have to shave it down to fit inside that tool, so it's not the most best tool if you have an early Jag. When early is basically like pre-2016 kind of deal. So if you have a 3-liter car, it works okay even if you have the earlier ones, but for your 5-liter guys, it might be a little bit of a hassle, or you might have to find a different route or this tool that I have here. Right, for this installation we recommend a hot plate, a regular hot plate, 1000 watt. You can probably get away with a 900 watt. You don't have to go overboard and say, I'm going to pick up a $100 piece for 1500 watts or something. Really, all you need is 1000 watt. The one I have here was actually on Amazon. I think it was like, man, $36 Canadian. So for American people, it's like, what, 20 bucks? So, or at least the current exchange rate. But basically, to summarize everything, you take the Griptec pulley. That's what I have here. Usually, this comes wrapped up in this little cellophane wrapper. Comes with the torque spec on it, right? So if you look carefully at the label, it actually has the torque spec of 5 foot-pounds, approximately 5 foot-pounds or 60 inch pounds, okay? And if you don't have that on there, well, it's actually on the box as well. So there's two spots where you have that torque spec. To know what pulley you have, it's written on the box, 58 mil, and it's also on the pulley, 58 mil, right? This is a two-piece design. Written on the pulley, it says shrink fit. This is not a press fit. Okay, you cannot use this pulley to press it on, this one. If you want a press fit, we can get you that. I don't know if the price is different or such. We don't stock it. We can order it from Griptec, and they can get us the hub for a press fit. But this is very simple. It's a shrink fit design. The stainless steel of this inner hub is 17-4 stainless, so it can contract nicely with heat. However, you can't use like a regular toaster oven. That's a method known on a lot of the German stuff, like the Audi 3-liter stuff like that. It's not going to get it hot enough. Okay, you can also use it. Some people do use a torch, but big disclaimer here: if you use a torch and it gets too hot, this will not shrink down enough. You've basically scrapped it. Okay, you'll have to buy a new hub. Now we do sell these hubs because of that. There are a lot of shops or people that will heat this up with like oxygen acetylene, and they get it glowing, and it doesn't shrink. It'll just slide on and off. Okay, so if that's one of you guys, you're gonna have to get a new hub, okay? You might be able to use something like, I don't think you'd be able to use propane. You might be able to use map gas, those yellow tanks, not the blue tanks. The map gas might get up to temp. I've never tried it though, okay? This method has been basically recommended to us by Griptec, ZPE. So we just use it, it's $36. Takes about 45 minutes to heat it up to temperature. And you don't have to sit there with a torch wasting your time heating it up. So you basically take the hub out, put it onto the plate, set it on max for 45 minutes. It should get it into the temperature in the range of 800 Fahrenheit. Okay. 800 Fahrenheit is the goal. That's what we want to get it to. If you go north of 950 Fahrenheit using torches and stuff, it ain't going to shrink down properly. So if you start baking at like 1000 Fahrenheit or over, getting it cherry red hot, it's too hot. Okay, so you do have a few devices that you can use here to make sure that you're not going to get over temperature and that you're actually at that temperature. We've got basically like an infrared gun, laser. Sometimes it doesn't work as great if you're on a shiny material. So it's always best to shine it on a non-shiny part, maybe the lettering, or you could even put something that's like a black paint or something onto the hub so you can get an adequate temperature. But honestly, when I've been doing this, even shining it on this stainless, it's been giving me an adequate temperature in that range. You don't need it exactly at 800, right? It could be at 802, 810. You just don't want to go over 950, okay, Fahrenheit. Another option that you have are melt sticks, right? This is pretty common in welding industry and such. You have different sticks that basically melt at the temperature. Now, a lot of people don't even know how to use these. They'll just think that you write it on like chalk, and then when it melts, that's the temperature that you basically need to, that it's at. Unfortunately, when you get up to the higher temperatures, like this one's actually a 750. I don't have an 8, but when you actually use this, you can't just draw on it when it's cold. You draw on it when it's hot, right? So when it starts to melt when it's hot, that's when you know it's at that temperature. So that's the way you're supposed to use these sticks. Not some videos where you just draw on it like chalk, and when the chalk melts, that's when it's at temp. Could work, but the hotter you get, or the higher you get in these sticks, they don't rub off like chalk. So people basically, they get a bad vibe or a bad rep for not actually working. When they do work, you just gotta have the thing hot, right? The thing meaning pulley. So you can use stuff like this to cool it down. Griptec recommends using compressed air. So you have basically compressed air and you'd be blowing on it, feeling the air that's coming off of it when it gets cold or of a warm temperature, not sort of a hot temperature, you know, you basically lower the temperature down to what it needs to be. Something that a lot of guys have used is water. We've used water too. It works. I haven't seen any warping. I haven't seen any cracking, but if you want to do it the actual Griptec way, they say to spray it with compressed air. Okay, so I just want to put that out there. You could use water, but if it warps it, cracks it, it's not warranted, it's not guaranteed. So if you want to follow the actual Griptec way, spend a little time getting it down, cooling it down slowly, you use air. If you're pressed for time or you're on a client's dime or whatever it may be and you want to get this thing in and out, water is pretty effective. Just make sure you block off areas like the throttle body, which is very close to the supercharger snout, so water didn't go in there. But that's a method that you could use. Blue Loctite. You can either use the gel form. I like using the gel. You can use a liquid form, just you get less of it when you're using the gel. You use a little dab of this on all the bolts when you put them in. These bolts, they are titanium, okay? And as I mentioned, what, they're like 5 foot-pounds, 60 inch pounds. They don't give you a sign when they're ready to snap. They don't stretch, they just snap. So don't try, a little bit, done. Okay, you're gonna have to get new bolts. And it doesn't look pretty when one of them is basically snapped. I've done it. I've snapped them. So I know I basically tried and tested and learned that. Doing it by hand kind of deal. And it just snapped. It is kind of easy to get them out because they're obviously not torqued in there tightly. So you just take the other screws out and you can literally finger tighten it out. You don't have to drill and extract it kind of deal. So as long as you're not cross-threading it, it's easy to come out. You just got to replace the screws after. So another thing. This little baby, this is the tool that ZP makes, aka Griptec. What they recommend, you take off all these screws. You take this little tool, okay? Inside this tool, there's a little snout stub, if you want to call it, and that's supposed to rest up against the snout. And just like that, my mic cut. So for the next minute, I'll just be narrating this next little bit. All right, so we've got the hub already on the hot plate. The hot plate's up to temperature. It's been on there for about 10 minutes. The hub itself with the tool. There's two screws holding the tool to the hub. And right now we're just measuring. I think I was at about 850. Grab the welding glove, get the compressed air, which is the Griptec method. Take the tool with the hub attached, put it onto the shaft. Make sure you hold it in place while you're cooling it, because if you don't hold it in place, it could walk the hub off and then you could be offset by a few mil. So make sure you hold it in place while you're cooling it. Make sure also to focus the air around the hub and the tool, because if the tool is still hot, it's going to be transmitting the heat back to the hub. Right now, we're just checking to see if it's around 80 to 90 Fahrenheit. At that point, we can basically just drizzle it with water to cool it down the remaining step. and right about the next seconds or so, my mic comes back, so there's no more narrating. All right, so right now, you obviously have your hub installed, take your tool off, and you're ready to install the outer race. Again, this is the 58 mil. If you wanted to install this 58 mil onto the 5 liter, you would have to shave this snout down. Now, just to give you that little information that I'm sure you're wanting, what size is the snout? So the snout is 48 mil, 47.9. That, so 47.9, 48, 47.9 to 48. So you're gonna wanna shave it down to that size so that you can fit this pulley, okay? This is a 3 liter, so I don't have any issue, and it already comes pre-done. Put the pulley on. You take your T30, grab your fandy dandy Loctite. Again, I use the gel, and it's only because I don't want it dripping all over the place. So put it in, thread them all in. Do this for all the remaining bolts. You obviously don't have to be too speedy. I know you're using Loctite. It takes about 20 minutes for it to start curing anyways. So you've got 20 minutes before it starts getting a problem. 14 is 24 hours before it cures. So you got more than enough time. You don't need to kill yourself. All right, so now that you've got all these screws in, hand tight, and there's no binding, right? Obviously, keep verifying there's no binding on this. I've got my torque wrench. I've got it set up to 60 inch pounds. You can use it at 5 foot-pounds. I like using it at inch foot-pounds because it lets me know that I'm almost at that position. So in this case, I'm using my reference point as the ZEP laser etching. I don't know if they're all like this, but you just basically take some indication or put a paint pen or such, and you get your torque wrench in there. You can hold the pulley. It's only 60 inch pounds. There's no reason why the average male can't hold it, and then just tighten it down. Right? You're going to do a star pattern, just like you tighten wheels. Same thing. Okay. Just keep walking around the pulley. Do this for all 10 screws. Once you've done all 10, now you're just going to basically do a verification going through all 10 again, going in a circular motion. All right, guys, there you have it. So basically what we've done is we've installed the hub, we've installed the outer ring, we've torqued these screws down, we put them with Loctite, they're torqued at 60 inch pounds or 5 foot-pounds, whichever method you want to use. We use all the recommended methods for this installation, at least. We use the tool, we use the hot plate, we got it up at 800 Fahrenheit. We didn't go over that 950. We know this pulley is not going to come off. So at this, at basically right now, you'd fit the belt, right? Fit the belt on there. The new belt that we provide, or the original that you have if you're installing just the upper and not the lower as well. Although you are fitting a new pulley, so it's always recommended just to install a new belt. So if you don't have the crank pulley and you're not getting a new belt with this, in that case, I would recommend sourcing a new belt from your dealer or the local parts store if you're fitting just the upper and not the crank pulley. But beyond that, everything is here for tool wise. We follow through all the methods. I hope I answered all those general questions in this video, but I know there are going to be some things that I might have gone over or zoomed right through. So if you do have any questions, don't be afraid. Do comment in this video below, or alternatively, you can reach me at my email, tuning@velocityap.com. Until then, guys, I hope this was enjoyed for you guys, and stay safe.